Hello student, I am Arnab Das. Today we discuss about the primitive element of Galois-Field Q. Primitive element of Galois-Field Q is a element alpha such that every field element except zero can be expressed as a power of L. So that means if you can able to identify the primitive element, then another elements can also be easily expressed by that particular primitive element. An element with order q minus of 1 in FQ is called the primitive element of FQ. So when you checking the primitive element for any Galois field, that time you should have also check what is the order, is it is following q minus of 1 or not. If it, then that kind of element can be a primitive element. For a finite field FQ, there exists a smallest number n such that beta to the power of n should equal to 1 for all value of beta belonging in F of Q, then n is called the order of the field element beta in F Q. Let me take an example for understand that particular term. Question is that determine the primitive element for F5. That means the field will be defined starting from 0 to up to 4, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 under mod 5. This is the field is given to you and you have to identify which one element out of this 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4, which one is the primitive element you should have to identify. So for this reason you have to check that initially what will be the primitive element order. As we know that in this case q for this field, q is defined as 5. So q minus 1 will be defined 5 minus of 1, that means 4. If the element order is 4, that time we can consider that element is an primitive element for that particular field. So for the individual element for this field, we have to check what is the order. So non-zero elements for this field are 1, 2, 3, 4. You have to neglect this 0 because non-zero element you have to take. This is 1, 2, 3 and 4. So we make a tabular form to identify so easily. First of all, if we consider for the 1, that time the order of 1 is 1. And why this is order of 1 is 1? Because single element can be created by this one. Now take 2. The second element, in this case, if you apply 2 as a power of 1, that time 2 will become as a result. So this one is present in this field. 2 to the power of 2 is equal to 4. So that one also present in this field. If you consider 2 to the power of 3, that time the result is 8. The operation you have to done as mod 5. So 8 you have to divide by 5 and what will be the remainder? That time the remainder will become as a 3 on there. So 2 to the power of 3 is equal to, for this kind of field, result equal to 3. This is also present in this field. 2 to the power 4 is defined 16. The mod of 16 for the 5 will be as a 1. because 5 into of 3 is 15 plus of 1, that means this is 16. So 1 is the result for 2 to the power of 4. So for the 2, each and every element you can got it on there. So for this reason, order of 2 is 4 on there. Same way you check for the 3. If you change the power for the 3, then individually you can check that each and every element can also got it by using 3. So here also order for the 3 is 4. If you consider for the 4, that time if you apply 4 to the power of 1, that means 4 squared is equal to 16 mod 5 is equal to 1. So in this case the 2 element is come out from the element 4. So here the order is for the 4 is 2. So 2 and 3 is the element where the order is 4. So 2, 3 are the primitive element for this field. So here also written that hence 2, 3 are the primitive element as their order is 4. So you can able to understand what is the primitive element and primitive element how can rearrange or can define the another elements of that particular field. An irreducible polynomial fx belonging in fpx, here we just consider q as a form of p for this position. Here polynomial variable are defined as a x of degree m is said to be primitive. Initially we just talking about the element, now we are talking about the polynomial form for the primitive one. An irreducible polynomial fx belonging in fpx of degree m is said to be primitive if smallest integer n such that fx fully divisible by x to the power of n minus of 1 is n equal to p to the power of m minus of 1. Here n is the smallest integer number, m is an any kind of integer number, p is defined the field element value. So this will be the notation you should be remember that an irreducible polynomial, what kind of condition should be fulfilled to represent this as a form of primitive one. A minimal polynomial defined for an element beta belonging to FQM is the smallest degree non-zero monic polynomial Px which is belonging in FQx such that P of beta should equal to 0. A polynomial is said to be monic polynomial if it is loading coefficient is unity. Already we discussed about this monic polynomial. Now take an example to identify the minimal polynomial. Question is that obtain the minimal polynomial for all elements in F2, 3 over F2. That is U or P, if you consider P for this field as element number. So this will be 2 on there. This is the 2 on there. And N is the degree for this field, that is 3 on there. M is equal to 3 and 2 is the P on there. So here N can be considered as a 7. Why? Because P to the power of M minus of 1, this is equal to N. So 2 to the power of m will be or minus of 1 will be equal to the 7. The question is that why this is 2 to the power of 3? Because p in the question is given as a 2. The question, this is 2, and m is given to as a value of 3. There the p is defined this one value and m is defined this one value. So 2 to the power of 3 is equal to 8 minus of 1, this is equal to 7, and this one is indicate the value for the n. So what will be the fx? To get the value of fx, px should be a one kind of function, minimal function, which can be divisible by x to the power of 7 minus of 1. So px will be degree of 3 also, because m is given to you as a value of 3. So px should be degree as a 3. Thus we can consider x to the power of 3 plus of x plus of 1, or x to the power of 3 plus of x square plus of 1 on there. So this one can easily can able to identify by the technique of x to the power 7 minus of 1 or x to the power 7 plus of 1 as a factorial form, and from that particular factorial you can check that these two values also come on there, and the px should be the degree 3. So there this any one of these two can be considered for representing this one for the value of px. Now let alpha a root of p of x. So this one are the define the p of x, and you now consider alpha is the root for that px. So if alpha is the root, then obviously if you put the value of alpha at the position of the x, then the value for the p of alpha will be equal to 0. We consider this one equation. So here p of alpha, you just replace x as value of alpha. So p of alpha is equal to alpha cube plus of alpha plus of 1 should be equal to 0, because alpha is the root. So from there you can write down alpha cube equal to alpha plus of 1. So there number of formation extension field, how many will be? It will be 7, because you already calculate the n is equal to 7. So here alpha, this position is defined alpha to the power of 0. Defined the alpha from the starting the 0, alpha to the power 1, 2, 3, up to 7. You just consider this one. If you come when the value for the alpha cube, that time alpha cube is equal to alpha plus of 1. You just put this value in this position. When you identify the value for the alpha 4, that time you can write down this is alpha 4 is equal to alpha into of alpha of cube. You already value of alpha cube is equal to alpha plus of 1, so this can be write down alpha into of alpha plus of 1. So this one value will be defined as a alpha square plus of 1, sorry, alpha. So this one is written in this position. If you check for the alpha to the power of 5, so alpha to the power of 5 can be write down as equal to the value of alpha into of alpha to the power of 4, which is equal to alpha into alpha square, because alpha 4 is equal to given alpha square plus of alpha. So this value will be defined as in alpha cube plus of alpha square. Alpha cube, you know the value, this is alpha plus of 1. So if you put this value, then it will be alpha square plus of alpha cube value define as the alpha plus of 1. So this one can be write down as if from this one, that is alpha square plus of alpha plus of 1 on there. Okay, so that one is written in this position, that one is written in this position. Now for the alpha 6, how can you got this alpha 6 on there? To identify the alpha 6 on there, that time alpha 6 can be write down as a alpha into of alpha 5. Alpha 5 is defined as a alpha square plus of alpha plus of 1. So this will be alpha cube plus alpha square plus of alpha. So this one can be write down as equal to alpha cube is equal to known as the alpha plus of 1, this position. So this is alpha square plus of alpha, alpha cube value, this is alpha plus of 1. So this is alpha plus of alpha, their value will be defined as a binary form or the mod 2 operation, 1 plus 1 is equal to 0. So alpha plus of alpha will be, coefficient value will be 1 plus of 1, that means it will be 0 on there. So this term will be omitted from this section. So ultimate answer for the alpha 6 will become as a alpha square plus of 1. So this is written as such, this one. Same way you can also write down for the what will be the value for the alpha 7. Alpha 7 is the 1. Why? Alpha 7 is equal to alpha into of alpha of 6. So this is alpha into alpha square plus of 1. So this value will be alpha cube plus of alpha. So alpha cube is defined alpha plus of 1. So this is alpha plus of alpha plus of 1. This is alpha plus of alpha is 0, and the ultimate value will be come on there only 1. So this is written in this position as value of only 1 on there. So we can able to identify the extension field of this one. So you can write down the extension field on there, and now we are interested to calculate the primitive element, you have to identify the conjugate of beta. What is the way by which you have to calculate the conjugate of beta? Initially, you just considered the root alpha is equal to beta. Then you have to consider root as a beta of q, then beta qd in such a way. So initially, if you consider beta is equal to alpha, because the roots are given to you as a 0 1 then alpha, alpha square up to alpha 6, as you already calculate from the extension field. Then conjugate class alpha, then it will be by using this form, this will be alpha square, because q is defined the 2 on there, because the field is written as a f2 of 3. So q is defined 2 and 3 is defined the m. So alpha cube will be alpha q will be defined as a 2. So this is alpha square. Then the beta into qd. So beta into qd is the as a alpha square. And then again square on there. So this is alpha 4 on there. Now again for the fourth one value, it is the alpha square square, then again square. So what will be the alpha to the power of 8? So this will be value of alpha. Why this is alpha? Because this is the mod of 7 operation, and you calculate this is n is equal to 7 already. So this is the mod 7 operation. So 8 mod 7 is equal to 1. So this is represent as the alpha. That means the again the value is coming back. This is alpha again, this value is coming back on there. So this is coming back as in this one. So if you take this is alpha square, then square, then again this position as value of 3, then it will be come back as a alpha square on there. So for this reason, this is not required to proceed the extra thing on there. So ultimately we can got it the conjugate class 1, that is the alpha, alpha square and alpha 4. If you check this one, then they are check that alpha cube is not present in this position. Alpha 5 and alpha 6 also are not present in this position. So you have to take beta value as a alpha cube, because already alpha square is used on there, alpha 4 is used on there to make the conjugacy class. So beta value now you have to check as a alpha cube. So if you put the value as a beta alpha cube, so then initially beta is the alpha cube, then beta of q, so q is there 2, so this is alpha cube of square, this is the alpha 6, then d qd, so this is 2 square, so this is alpha 12, mod value of 12 by of 7, that means the 12 mod 7 will be defined the alpha of 5. So this is written as such. This will be again come back, if it is as a value of 3, then it is come back alpha of q. So another step not required to do in this case. So ultimately the conjugacy classes, the elements are alpha cube, alpha 6 and alpha 5. Now check that alphas, alpha square, alpha 4 up to alpha 6, each and every element or roots are used for making the conjugacy class. So now the beta value not have to change in this case. So this two conjugacy class by using this root can be created. Now we have to check that how many number of conjugacy class can be formed for the F23. So for the F23, that one class is 0, one class is 1, one is calculated by beta value as the alpha is alpha, alpha square and alpha 4. Another one is defined as the alpha cube by putting the value beta as the alpha cube, alpha cube, alpha 6 and alpha 5. This all elements in a conjugacy class will have the same minimal polynomial. Therefore, for the zero, this will be minimal polynomial will be defined as a zero. You just use as a subtract of this one. So this will be x. When you consider one, that time subtract one. So this will be the another one, but it also written as a x plus of one also. So this will be the further case. Now the minimal polynomial of this one is alpha, alpha square, alpha 4. It will be x minus of alpha for first element, then x minus of alpha square as a factorial of it multiplied x minus of alpha square, then alpha to the power of 4. This is x minus of alpha to the power of 4. Now the last one, conjugacy is defined. Okay, now you can individually can put this multiplication process. So if you do this multiplication between these two, that time the result will become this one, and then left this one present. Then again you multiply this one. So ultimately the value will become this one. Now check that here, this value, what is coming on there? If you do the common process or any other thing, that time that look at here element, this one element are the both same. So this is 1 plus of 1, this element will be 0. So this will be omitted from this section. This is also the omitted from this section, alpha x plus of alpha x, so that one also. Here x plus of x plus of x, so this will be 1 plus of 1 plus of 1. So 1 plus of 1 is 0, then again 0 plus of 1 is 1. So here only a single x will be present. So look that there only x is present on there. And lastly, there 1 is present, and this one also omitted from this, because alpha square x again come as the alpha square x. So 1 plus of 1 is again come on the 0. So only this 1 is present. So this is the 1. So for the third conjugacy class, we can able to identify primitive polynomial as a form of this one. Okay. Now for the fourth one, the similar process for this one, you have to initially put the x minus of alpha cube for this one. This is x minus of alpha for this one, and for the x to the power alpha to the power 6, it will be x minus of alpha 6. Then you have to do the multiplication process and check the what is the result will become on that. If the same result is come as the 2 times, then it will be omit. If this is 3 times, then you have to use only single time. If it is again 4 times, then it will be again 0 in such a way. Just do the mod 2 addition on there. So ultimately for this, minimal polynomial will become as a value of x cube plus of x square plus of 1. So I think each and everyone can able to identify what will be the minimal polynomial and what is the process by which you have to identify minimal polynomial. So I think each and everyone can able to understand. Next day we come with another one point, and till have a good day. And now I have to say